Welcome to this quick start of n8n, the powerful workflow automation platform. From simple syncs and notifications to automating complex processes and even building back-end functionality. With hundreds of nodes for your apps and services, as well as ample core nodes, the sky really is the limit. Let's check out the basics of workflow creation with a simple example. So in this flow, each time someone submits this type form survey, I'd like to post that into this Slack channel as a message. So I've got my type form trigger node in my workflow here. Trigger nodes in n8n kick off workflows, and then we have regular nodes that perform steps. It's set up, and so the next step is to execute my workflow. It's going to enter a listening state, and we're going to pull in some mock data from Typeform. So let's go create that mock data. Back in n8n, we see the workflow executed successfully. If I double-click on the Typeform trigger, we can see that we've pulled in that form response data, and so now we need to add the Slack node to the canvas, and we send that data into the Slack node. So I'll drag that onto the canvas. Next, we'll connect the Typeform trigger to the Slack node. And then the first step in the Slack node is to set up the credentials. In this case, I'm using an OAuth2 credential, so I'll select an existing one I have. The resource we're operating on is a message because we want to send a message. The operation in this case is we're posting that message. The channel name we'd like to send to is the demo requests channel. And then the text that we'd like to send, this is where we'd like to map dynamic data from our Typeform trigger. So we'll add an expression to this field. And then in the expression editor, we can combine static text, like new demo request here. And then we can explore data available early in our workflow, like in the Typeform trigger. And we can click to add that to our flow and combine that static text along with this dynamic data. Here beneath in the result, you can see the rendered result. This is what we'll send to Slack. So now if I execute just the Slack node, we can see we got a response from Slack, and if we check, that data was posted. So now that I've tested the workflow, the next step would be to activate it. So if it's deactivated, you'll want to activate it. And this will make sure that the workflow will fire automatically each time the trigger condition is met, or in this case, each time someone fills out this form. And to see your active executions, you're going to want to check out the executions log here. Now, you'll notice the start node here. This is also a trigger node. It's used to manually run your workflow. Most of the time, I'm using an app-based trigger, so I'm tucking it away. You'll find it useful to understand how n8n handles multiple items of data. So let's take a look at this example. In the customer data store node, we're doing a get all people operation. So we have 5 items of data. Each one is a person. As we can see, each has their own row in this table. We're then sending those 5 items into this if node here. I've set it up to be checking if that item of data or that person is coming from the US. If they are, we're routing it to the true branch. Otherwise, it goes to the false branch. So we can see 5 items go in, 2 go to the true branch, and 3 to the false branch. And then in the customer messenger node, this is sending a message for each item of data coming in. We can see 2 items flow in, and so 2 messages have been sent, 1 for each item of data. So by default, n8n's nodes perform their configured step on each item of incoming data. Make sure to check out our template library for workflow inspiration on what to automate first.